Let's work through the following example together. Compute the dot product of vectors u and v and find the angle between them. Vector u is 3i minus 4k, and vector v is 2i minus 4j plus k. All right, so probably the first step we want to do here is go ahead and rewrite vectors u and v as position vectors, or in component form. Right now, they're written using the coordinate unit vectors, which is fine, but it'll just be a little easier for us to think about if we see the components written out. So vector u is 3i minus 4k. So remember, I is the x direction, j is the y direction, and k is the z direction. So then this is component 3 in the x direction. And then the y component is 0. And the z component is negative 4. And then for vector v, the x component is 2, y component negative 4, and z component 1. Okay, so the directions first of all state to compute the dot product and then to find the angle between them. And we know two formulas for computing the dot product, so let's think about which one we want to use in this case. So the two formulas we know are that u dot v equals the magnitude of u times the magnitude of v times cosine theta, and then also u dot v equals u1 v1 plus u2 v2 plus u3 v3. Now, since what we're ultimately looking for is the angle between the vectors, okay, so what we're looking for is theta, we probably don't want to use this first definition that includes cosine theta, because we don't know theta, that's what we want to find. So what we want to use to compute the dot product is actually this second definition here, and then once we have that, we'll be able to actually find theta. Okay, so then let's go ahead and compute u dot v. Okay, so u1 times v1, so u1 is 3, that just refers to the x component, or the first component of u, and v1 is 2, plus u2 is 0, v2 negative 4, and then plus u3 v3, so that should be negative 4 times 1. Okay, so that looks like 6 plus 0 minus 4, so 2 is the dot product. The dot product gives us a scalar quantity. Okay, so dot product is 2. Now what I can do is I can use the other definition to solve for theta, which is what I ultimately want to find. So here's my other definition. U dot v equals magnitude of u times magnitude of v times cosine theta. Okay, so I'm interested in knowing theta, so let's solve this for theta. So let's see. I get u dot v over magnitude of u times magnitude of v equals cosine theta. And then if I wanted to solve for theta, I could take the inverse cosine of both sides, or the arc cosine, same thing. So arc cosine of this expression equals theta. All right, so we already know what u dot v is. We just computed that as 2, but we need to know what the magnitude of u and the magnitude of v are to finish computing theta. So out to the side here, let's just go ahead and compute those. So magnitude of u, I'm looking back up here where I have my components, so it's going to be the square root of 3 squared plus 0 squared plus negative 4 squared. So that's a square root of 9 plus 16. So that's a square root of 25, which is 5. And then magnitude of v is a square root of 2 squared plus negative 4 squared plus 1 squared. So that's a square root of 4 plus 16 plus 1, So square root of 21. All right, so now we can plug in all those values and actually compute theta. Okay, so theta equals the arc cosine of u dot v, which is 2, over mag u, magnitude of u, which is 5, we said, times the magnitude of v, which is square root of 21. Okay, and then we just need to compute what this actually is. So I'm going to put that in the calculator for us and see what we... All right, so it looks like for theta, we get approximately 1.48 radians. Or in degrees, that is 84.99 degrees. All right, so this is the angle between the vectors u and v, computed by using the dot product.